You folks see that flashing sign up there? Now that sign says applesauce. No. I'm kidding. It says applause. Ray, do me a favor. Could you flick that once? All right. Now, remember, you're all a big part of the show, so the better you are, the better Larry is. Okay, now you see this gentleman? Now he's giving me this sign, and it says, we're on in 10 seconds, so get ready to have a good time. All right, here we go. This is exciting, isn't it?
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
Live on tape from Hollywood, The Larry Sanders Show. Tonight, join Larry and his guests, Angelica Houston, the Black Crow, and comedian Jeff Cesario. And now, because he couldn't find the exit door, Larry Sanders!
Mike Tyson was quoted as saying in an interview last week that, quote, I'm in love with myself. Sorry, girls. That's it. That's that joke. The United States Post Office has decided to use both Elvis stamps. Did you know this, by the way?
No, I did not.
I just discovered this. They're using the young Elvis stamp for a standard mail, and the old Elvis stamp for packages over 300 pounds. We have a wonderful show tonight. Angelica Houston, the Black Crowes, Jeff Cesario, who already get well soon, who's watching at home.
Now, are you headed for the long one? Because I'm amazed by these people who are married like 60, 70 years. They stay married forever. The only time you hear about it, when somebody passes away. Like the wife married 7 years, she'll pass away.
Yeah.
And then, like, a week later, the husband dies.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and everybody always says, that's love. Well, maybe it's love. Maybe she just didn't tell him where she put his medication.
Very funny. Very funny stuff tonight.
Thanks,
oh,
Len.
Gee. I guess we're out of time. I hope you'll come back again sometime.
Anytime. Thanks for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Jeff Cesario. And I want to say... Again, to Artie, who I know is watching, our producer, get well soon. Artie had that emergency appendectomy, and he'll be back very soon, I hope.
Yes, Arthur, come back soon. We miss your cigar smoke in the hallway.
I would like to quickly introduce our producer who's been standing in for Artie, Jonathan Lippman, my good friend. Come on out here a second and say hello.
Jonathan,
thank you.
You're doing a wonderful job. I just wanted to thank you. How long have we known each other now?
Oh, I don't know, 1980, the BBC, when you came over.
That's right.
Little...
We're out of time. So, stay tuned for whatever's after
Portia.
This show.
Not once in 6 years tonight. Did he ever invite me up on the stage. Horseshit.
¿Qué?
Nunca en 6 años, nunca me he invitado a subir al foro. ¿Cómo se dice horseshit? ¿Caballo caca?
Caca de caballo.
Eso.
Tienes que tomar la medicina.
¿Qué pasa with Jeff Cesario sitting with the panel? First time he's up there as a stand-up. Jesus, muy malo. This is a very bad precedent. Come on, a little tequila.
No, tequila, no.
Nina, don't you see? My show is being taken over by a guy. It looks and sounds like Vanessa Redgrave. Come on.
Okay. But... David Letterman, por favor.
Okay.
A really very, very funny show last night.
Thank you. What was your favorite part?
Oh, I love that part where you go and walk.
Hey, Larry. Great audience last night.
Yeah, it was, Phil. What's with Phil's fucking nose?
Excuse me, Larry. Larry? Sam Fitzgerald, new head of late night programming.
Oh, Sam, hi. Nice to meet you. Hey, what happened to Melanie Parrish?
Maternity leave.
Gee, I didn't even know she was pregnant.
She isn't. Let's just leave it at that, okay?
Larry. Oh, hey, Jonathan, I'd like you to meet Sam Fitzgerald of the network.
Jonathan?
Sam.
And by the way, the network has read your memo, and the suggestions for the show are very exciting.
Hey, let's talk about it in my office.
Terrific. Hey, Larry, I saw the show last night. Good new ideas.
Thank you.
Yeah, they were Jonathan's.
I had a feeling they were. Jonathan, I'm a big fan of your work. I mean, I love the Cinemax thing you did with Damon Wayans, and that MTV Young Comedians thing, may I say, you really rocked me.
Maybe you're too easily roped.
So, Larry, when are we going to implement some of the points Jonathan brought up in the memo?
You know, I've been actually asking Larry the same thing. Larry.
I think they are good ideas. I think we should just consider them one at a time. You know, Sam, too much change too soon isn't good for the system. You know that.
Well, with Carson gone now, it's anybody's race.
I agree with Sam.
Now's the time to really make a move. Look, we can pass Arsenio, we can pass Leno. Yeah. Gentlemen, this is no time for a pit stop.
Does this mean we have to start wearing jumpsuits, Sam? Because I think only Hank has one. Thanks for coming by, Sam.
Sure.
And by the way, it goes without saying this memo's not for general distribution, huh?
Oh, Larry, please. If there's one thing I'm known for, it's my complete discretion.
Good. Hey, what really happened to Melanie Parrish, by the way?
Well, you didn't get this from me, but her live-in boyfriend left, mm-hmm. and she tried to kill herself with an overdose of Halcyon.
Wow.
Is that right?
She's okay. Let's just leave it at that, okay?
Why?
She wasn't pregnant then.
This business will do that to you.
I got the memo!
Score, Mandu! Niceness. How'd you get it, man?
It's right on Larry's desk. Right in a folder, under some papers.
Uh-huh.
In a drawer that was locked. I was finding the key that was a bitch.
Number one, new graphics. They did that. Mm-hmm. Number two, there's no reason first-time stand-ups can't do panel. Number three, the guitar player's chronic marijuana abuse is a problem. Must do something about that. What's it? They're taking that shit seriously.
What else is in there?
Here we go. As far as the writing's concerned, the monologues are getting soft and predictable like Leno's. Of all the writers, Phil seems to be the man to take control of this.
Well, Phil seems to be the man to take control. Unfortunately, Phil's social maladjustment runs so deep that he is unpredictable and volatile. My guess is that he talks badly about Larry behind his back. Oh, right. You know, Larry is just the kind of asshole to read that and believe it.
Yeah, the memo is way off.
Social maladjustment, what the hell does that mean? You know, now I'm sorry I made copies of this for everybody.
Memo didn't say anything bad about you, Darlene.
No, but, you know, it said as far as Hank is concerned, uh-huh. the show could certainly benefit from a sidekick who skews more towards the younger audience. Hank is very sensitive about his age. He's only 34.
Hank is not 34, Darlene.
Shh.
What?
How did you find out? Well, anyway, whatever age he isn't that much older than Larry.
Right here, Darlene is the most competent person in the office.
I didn't see that.
It's not actually here.
Oh.
But it should be. Mm. Yeah.
That is great. Okay. Stay tuned. We'll talk more about the book Shirts Come in All Colors.
Claire!
What are you doing?
I was going to move the plant.
Well, why are you moving it now?
First, Arthur tells me to put more plants on the set.
Uh-huh.
Now I hear from this memo that there's too many plants on the set.
The memo.
Listen, Mr. Sanders, if you don't like the job I do on any particular plant, just tell me to my face.
This is,
I went through the same shit once with Sajak.
I'm going to get right to the point. The reason I called you here is because I know there's this memo going around, and I'm pretty pissed off about it because it wasn't supposed to get around. This memo does not reflect how I feel about things, and I disagree with the things on that memo.
Like what?
Like what? I don't have the memo committed to memory. All right. Who, does somebody have a copy?
No.
All right, I can see what's going on. Okay, I'll turn around, and somebody put the memo in front of me. Very funny, very fucking funny. Okay, this thing about the plants, let's start there. I don't agree with that. I think you can never have enough vegetation. Ask Sting.
What in the monologue, the joke's being soft and predictable.
Sorry, I'm late. What's up? Oh, my God, we've been canceled.
No, we are talking about something else. We have not been canceled.
Well, what is it? He's already dead? Go ahead. I can take it.
We're discussing the memo, Hank.
What memo?
Don't act dumb.
That's an insult. I'm not acting dumb. I don't know what memo. I'm sorry, but that's how I feel.
I'm sorry. They'll tell you about it. Tell them about the memo. It already died.
Do you believe this shit?
Excuse me, Jonathan? No.
Larry, Diane here has convinced me that as far as the carpet's concerned, we really ought to go with something more direct.
Listen, Jonathan, we have a situation here.
I know, Larry. I know. Excuse me, Diane.
How did this happen? That memo was in my desk, in a folder, under some papers, in a drawer that was locked. What do I need, a fucking security camera?
Yeah, well, you know, I covered that on page 3 of the memo.
Yeah, well, maybe I should get one before I get shot.
Larry, can you just relax?
Relax? My entire staff is paranoid. They all think they're going to be replaced.
So?
So?
Yeah, so maybe they'll have to work a little bit harder. Uh-huh. Maybe the show will become a little bit funnier. Who knows? Maybe the fucking coffee will become a little bit hotter.
Uh-huh.
You know, Larry, from my own experience, fear is a great motivator.
Yeah, well, I don't think I want people to fear me, Jonathan. Respect me, fine. Think I'm attractive and a great dancer, fine.
Okay.
But let's draw the line there, okay?
Okay, do me a favor. Why don't you let this whole thing just play itself out, okay? Huh? I mean, do you really think people are working as hard as they can around here? Larry, do you really think you're getting the respect that you deserve? Huh?
Come on.
Answer me, Larry.
All right, look, we'll play it out. But Artie cannot find out about this.
Oh, come on, Artie.
Especially the plant thing. That greenery balance on the set has been one of his pet projects for years. You gotta promise me it doesn't get back to him.
Visually, the guests get lost in all the plants. It's like a jungle out there. Sometimes when I flip past the show on TV, it looks like an old Tarzan movie. Horseshit. Esso, this isn't about those plants. This is about me. I am those plants, goddammit.
Cabron.
Hijo de chingada.
What have you heard?
About what?
Good. It's being contained. They are cleaning house. No one is safe.
What?
Fool me, agents.
Neither do I walk through the valley in the shadow of death.
Sid Bessel, please. Hank Kingsley calling.
I will fear no evil, for thou art my rod and my... Sid. Jonathan Littman is taking over the Sanders show. He hates my work. Don't you remember? He fired me from that QE2 Fourth of July special. Protect me, Sid. Come on, protect me. This goes no further. Where was I?
For thou art my rod.
And my staff, thou makest me to lay down in green pastures.
Larry.
Darlene, I can't see Hank.
Hank would like to. Oh.
Yeah.
I can't. Not right now.
You want to see me?
No.
No?
No.
What the hell's going on?
What is it? The memo? The ideas contained in that memo are not my ideas, Hank. I do not happen to think we need a younger sidekick.
Thank you.
What is that?
What do you mean, this?
Yeah.
You mean the earring?
The earring.
Well, I've had this. I've had this for, oh, golly, some time now.
Bullshit. You've gotten an earring to make yourself look younger.
Oh, no.
Oh. What have you done to your nipples?
Hey, now.
Let me see. No. Come on, let me see. Sit down. Oh, sit down. Sit down. Hank.
What? What's wrong?
Uh-oh.
What's wrong?
Hank, what? Look that way. Look that way. Look
good.
Up.
Right.
Look down.
All right.
Does that loosen you up? How's that feel?
Good.
Oh, boy.
Hey.
Does this hurt?
Yes.
Oh, boy. Where'd you get this done, Hank?
Well,
you know, was it in a sterile environment? Look that way.
Yeah.
Boy, very swollen and reddish, Hank.
Really?
And the left ear is the gay ear, by the way. Do you know that?
It is.
Uh-huh. And when you wear it low on the lobe like that, Hank, it means you're catching, not pitching. You know, I had a friend who was allergic to base metal, got a really bad infection, lost about 90% of his hearing. Oh, yeah. Hank, that looks very pussy. What kind of metal did they use? Do you know?
I gotta go.
Oh, I'm sure it's fine. Hank,
yeah.
I like it. Hank, keep it.
Yeah. Keep it.
Yeah.
All right.
Boy, oh boy. Don't hide it.
All right.
Be proud, catching, not pitching.
All right. Call me an ambulance.
Close that door.
Arthur, what are you doing here?
I'm preparing to say goodbye.
Oh, no, no. Come on. Come on. Come on.
It's Demerol, you ass, and tequila. It's a good mix.
Heard about the memo, huh?
Are you kidding? You think there's anything that goes on around here that I don't know about? If somebody farts in the Xerox room, I've heard about it. Listen, nothing gets by me. Nothing. What the hell's in your ear?
Earring.
Well, get rid of it, for God's sake.
I can't. Larry likes it. He says he wants me to keep it. Artie, I think it's infected. I can hear something inside my head.
I guarantee you there's nothing in there, Hank. Here, drink this.
No, thanks. No, I got a show tonight, and I'm obviously going to be under a massive program of antibiotics.
Drink it. I'll knock you down on the floor, I'll put my foot on your neck, and I'll piss in that good ear.
Nostrovio.
Hey. Hey, Chihuahua. Hank. Never get sick. If there's one cardinal rule in show business, it's never get sick. It's when you're down, when you show the slightest weakness, that they slip that knife in your back.
Darlene, I'm feeling better, so just cancel that ambulance. Artie, do you think you're really out?
Of course I'm out.
But Jesus, Artie, if you're out, we're all out.
I have to admire that little Iago. Jonathan Lippman. You know, he played it brilliantly. You know?
Artie, I want you to be honest with me. I'm going to ask you something of a very, very personal nature.
No, go right ahead.
No, please, hear me out. I mean, I've never said anything like this to another human being. So, okay, I'm just going to say it, okay? Artie, do you think I skew to an older demographic?
It's all bullshit. This is just change for the sake of change. It's a gimmick in Hollywood. It has nothing to do with the way any of us do our jobs. It's flavor of the month. And Hank, what the hell are you doing here?
I'm sorry.
That's the way this town runs. Competence, professionalism, loyalty. They're not words in Hollywood vocabulary.
Artie, what's going to happen to me?
Too sad to even think about.
Oh, God. Regis Philbin. Come on, Artie. Regis Philbin, he came back.
So what do you want to do? You want to sit there while Kathy Lee prattles on in your good ear about how Frank hates to change Cody's poopy diapers?
Fuck me.
Piece of shit. Oh, don't worry about us. We have options. Does the name Sally Jesse Raphael mean anything to you?
Sally, Jesse, Raphael?
Yeah, cousins will fuck is the first topic.
Oh, I see. Arthur, you shouldn't be up. You just had surgery.
Ah, but that knife was wielded by a relative stranger.
You're as young as you feel. That's what they say.
Jesus, Artie, you got Hank drunk.
Hank's his old man. He does whatever he wants. Sit down there, Hank.
Yes. Oh, please. Please let me take this earring out. I can't hardly see. And the infection is going right to my optic nerve.
Larry fucking cares about your fucking eye. Would fucking care if that infection ran right in straight into your brain, swelling it to such a grotesque size that the skull burst like a ripe honeydew melon. I saw a case like this in Korea once. Hey, I mean, it was a horrible, painful way to die. Yeah, the screams still haunt me. So where's your friend now, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. The whiz kid.
Put up with such shit. From this memo.
Get off it! You just couldn't wait to get that butthole buddy of yours in here.
Hey.
Because you don't want anybody in here who will challenge you.
That is...
You don't want anybody. You just want people that fear suck up to you.
Hardy, could we please talk about this at another time? I think you've been drinking and you're under medication. And Artie, I put up enough with that from the writers, don't I?
There won't be another occasion, sonny boy. Cause I quit.
This is fucking nuts.
Hey! Is it now? We look like nuts to you?
I'm fairly satisfied.
Hank just threw up in my wastebasket, and Artie had a drunken tantrum. He thinks he's out.
Right?
Yeah, and he thinks we're hiring you to take his place.
Is that right?
That's right. What I need is, I need you, Jonathan, to come with me right now. We're going to find Artie, and we're going to tell him you are not interested in taking his job. Sam, I'd like you to go with me.
I don't know that we can do that, Larry.
Larry, I think Sam's reluctance to placate Arthur is based on his knowledge of my, and this is a somewhat embarrassing admission, but my enthusiastic and aggressive interest in taking his job and producing the show.
Are you serious?
Larry, we at the network love the direction the show's taken the last couple of weeks.
Oh, hold it. Okay, I can see what's happening here. I'm the schmuck in this story, aren't I?
I'm just saying that we would not be unhappy if Jonathan were to take over as producer of the show.
When you say us, you mean the network?
Yeah.
You mean the entire network?
Huh? Sheldon is behind this 100%.
He is?
Yeah. Call him if you think we're lying.
You know, Sheldon and I are really close.
Okay, we're lying.
Hi, Ginny, honey. I'll be home around 8, okay? All right. Just want to love you, too.
All right, Larry, I suppose we did make one slight little tactical error. We did not have you on board from the very beginning, but I have to say my most egregious mistake was overlooking our friendship, my somewhat lusty pursuit of this job, okay? I admit it.
Have I ever told you, John, I can't stand the way you talk?
Well, I think we're done here.
What is this? One of Sanders' weaknesses is that he doesn't have a stable of beloved characters a la Karnak, Aunt Blabby, etc.
Hurry.
Obviously, you guys don't know about my Chinese weatherman. It's freezing! It's freezing!
Yeah. Lane and I are going to buy that place we always dreamed about in Puerto Vallarta. Sitting on a veranda over the blue Pacific, watching the sunset, counting the pelicans.
Artie, just hear me out about this. You know, I can't do this show without you. I don't want to do the show without you. You're the reason that I'm here, because you've trusted me, you've had faith in me right from the beginning.
That's right. Like the first week, When you couldn't hold down solid food?
Remember you held my head? I don't want some new guy holding my head.
Hey, thanks. Remember that day when we spent the entire morning readjusting these damn plants? Hey, listen, you are the one who, you wanted these plants.
Yeah.
But then you got upset. You got upset because you said you couldn't see the Hollywood sign or the sunset.
Well, you know, sunrise.
Sunset. It's a nighttime show.
No, but it's a sunrise. We're facing east. So
west.
It's actually the sun rising.
West. You consider that stuck-up little shit, didn't you?
I had every right to consider him, Artie.
Damn right you did. I taught you well.
Artie, well, come on. What do you think? I just would dump someone I love just because some new good-looking guy comes along?
You know, I'm always telling you how funny you are and how your clothes fit and how your ass doesn't look fat in pants. I don't do that because I have to. I do it because I love you, you bastard. I don't want you to see me like this.
So, you're gonna stay, right?
Okay.
Thanks,
Tommy.
Hey, Larry.
Hey, Morty. You know Robert Morton?
Yeah, how could I forget him? Co-exec producer for the Letterman Show, right?
Yeah, we're having lunch today.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Artie, it is just lunch.
Uh-huh.
Come on. We're just having lunch, I swear to God. Great to see
you,
Morty.
Great to see you.
How are you? How are you?
I'm great.
Sure.
Thank you.
Hey, you know my producer, Artie.
Sure. Hi, Artie.
Morty, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thanks. Man, you guys sure have a lot of fucking plants on this set.
Don't miss The Late Show with David Letterman at midnight with guests Kelly Ripper and Hilary Duff. That's followed by Invasion Iowa. Dream On is next.